What does the coroner's office need to improve efficiency in its office?
I think the first thing is looking at time and response to the scene. Also looking at accurate information being received and then making that first notification. And one of my pet peeves has always been working within law enforcement is being able to go and sit down with family members. That is one of the things that I feel makes a big impression on what they're doing and what they're hearing to understand what's happened to their loved one.
Two, what is your plan to fight opioid abuse and deaths?
The unfortunate thing is whenever the coroner's office gets called, it's too late. I feel like getting out in front of the opioid epidemic, if we'll call it that, is being able to educate, getting to family, getting to friends, making sure they know what signs to look for, what to understand, and how to respond if they have a loved one that is exposed to the opioids. And then the biggest thing is being able to have resources available for them.
Three, if the coroner's office had an influx of money, what would you spend it on?
I think the biggest thing that coroner's office are faced with is getting toxicology reports back. We rely on the South Carolina Law Enforcement Division as well as other law enforcement agencies and coroner's office. So I would ask take that money and outsource it so that we can have a quicker turnaround on the toxicology to get back to family members, because that really truly helps aid in getting back to the death certificate and cause of death to get to funeral homes and family.
Four, how should a coroner's success be measured?
A coroner's success should be measured by their loyalty, their dedication, their compassion. A coroner has to have certain ministerial rights because they are going to make notifications. And I truly believe a coroner, whenever they enter into the homes of an individual, they're there to be the embracing arms, the shoulder to cry on, and then to get the resources to give them for counseling and different things along that line to help them better themselves in the acceptance of what's going on.